Hi guys, I'm Habib from Tattoo Lab Kid. Today I'm going to introduce you to PowerPoint. PowerPoint is a very useful and powerful tool. Okay, let's start. Okay, this is my desktop. And in this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to open PowerPoint. Okay, this is PowerPoint. I click it. And the next thing, we're going to learn about all the tabs in the ribbon. This is the ribbon, and in the ribbon we have File, Home, Insert, Draw, Design, and Transitions. We're going and Animations, and New Tab. New Tab is a new tab in the ribbon. You can add new groups here. You will learn all of that in the next lesson. But let's start in File. This is the backstage of PowerPoint. When you open PowerPoint, it will take you here first. If you want to find new ideas, you can come here and more themes. You can find lots of these. And if you go back, you want to find your old saved projects, you can come down here. Recent pinned. No, share with me. Recent. And next we have new, you can create new projects, we can open new project, info, and save. You can save your project, save as, you can save your project in another place, like in PC, in OneDrive. And next we can print it, we can print this side. This slide, and you can share it to your friends and export. You can create a PDF document, create a video, or create an animated gif, or make a CD. And next we have home. Home is a tab in the ribbon, the second tab in the ribbon. Okay, this is paste. I'll show you how to copy and paste things. Okay, example, we make a perfect circle right here. And then you want to copy and paste it. We will have two. We just click this, copy, and then paste. Now we have two. Or you can when you put the mouse cursor on it, you'll see that copy is Control C. That's the short key of copy, and this Control V is the short key for paste. And let's try that. Control C and Control V. It worked. Or if you want to make double of it way more easier, it's Control D for duplicate. And next we have new slide. You can take blank or even slide title. And next we have reuse slide. Reuse slide is where you can choose one of your old project slide and layouts. You can take a slide and research. You can research your slide or section. And next, here in font, you can write something. And this is the settings where you can build the slide. Like example, I come to insert and I get the text box and I want to write something like my name, PIB, and I want to make it bigger. I just need to select all and come to a home, and as you can see now, you can make it bigger clicking this, or you can do this 66. You can make it even bigger, or you can change the color like red, or this, and it's blue, or you can change the background, but don't need a background. And you can change the font, you can change the font style, You can make it bold. And next, in home you have shapes where we can take lots of shapes from, like recently used shapes, lines, rectangles, basic shapes, blocks and arrows, equation shapes, flow charts, stars and banners, callouts, and action buttons. We'll learn all of those in next lesson. Arrange front, you can bring it to the front, see, and bring it forward, bring it backwards, back, and align center. You can do lots of duplicates of them, make them smaller, each one smaller. And I want to put this all in the middle. And you go to arrange, align, align center, arrange, align, align middle. No, you must select all first. And then you arrange, align, align center, arrange, align, align middle. If you don't select all, it won't work. If I select all of these, I will go center, that's all. And group right here, group option. I just need to select the thing you want to group. Group objects, and you group it, and that's one. If you want to ungroup it, you can go ungroup, or you want to regroup it back, you can regroup. But let's ungroup it first now. And this is fill shape. You can change the, especially for shapes, you can change the color. Like, I want this one to be orange. And this back one right here, red. And shape outline. You can even make the outline even thicker if you want, or stretch like that, wobbly, straight, or maybe dash. Let's put no outline for all of these, no outlines. That looks cool. You can even try to make a target. But we'll learn how to make all that in the next lesson. There. And then you can find something, replay, select, DK, design ideas. You can find designs. And next we have insert, new slide, and reuse slide again. And table. You can find table, insert table, draw table, or Excel spreadsheet. Excel is another Microsoft Word tool. You'll learn all of Excel in the next lesson. And pictures you can take from this device. Pictures, download, or in pictures here. You can take this Tesla car here and take it from this my computer device, and this doc image, and this one online. If you have Wi-Fi at home, you can take it online, like airplanes. If you want to just insert it, you can just click insert and it's here. Okay, next we have screenshots. Screen clipping, take a screenshot, and we have a photo album, and we have shapes icons. You can take icons, cool icons, and add it to your presentation there. Or 3D models, The different things about 3D models and shapes are because 3D models, like spheres, like this round one, and example, another circle, they're not the same. This sphere, you can spin it. As you can see, I'm spinning it. Can spin it. It's 3D. This one, I can't. I cannot spin it. I can only spin it like this. I can see only one side. I can only spin around, but I can't see the whole side. And this, I can spin it all over, like a spinning ball. And if you want to insert in smart art, you can find lots of cool things, and also charts like pie. You'll learn all of these in next lesson. And forms, get add-ins, my add-ins, zoom something, or link to link something. Like, I want to link that spear. When I click that spear, it will take me, you place this document, you click that, and you want to, when you click it, you want it to change to which slide, like this last slide, or next slide, this is the next slide, or previous slide. I mean slide titles, but for me, I want to go the third slide. Let's go to slideshow, that, and I click it. It takes me to the third slide. It takes me to the third slide directly. It skips the second slide. Since I link this spear, okay. Next, we have actions. Like when you play sound, when you click it, click sound. Let's check example, like, see, did you hear the sound? That's how. And now comment, text box, you can add a text, you can write something, and then we have header and footer, board art, which you can write something. Like, hello. And next, we have draw. Let me make a new slide first. And we go to draw. Draws where you can draw a masterpiece or something, like a wiggly line. Or use this red pen. Draw a certain masterpiece, or this cool crayon, and next this one, so thin, and this highlighter, you can highlight something, and if you want to erase all, you can take an eraser, easy. And next, a ruler, you can draw a straight line, especially using a highlighter. And after that, you click the ruler again, you see that is straight. And I remove them. And ink to text, ink to shape, ink to mask, ink replay. And next, we have design, which they have design ideas. You can take this one or this one, or if you want to see more, you can just click the small here. You can choose your own favorite icon, your favorite design, and you can add colors, fonts, effects, office, and background styles. And next, we have transitions. Transitions is where you can animate the slide Like this first slide, I want it come like this fracture, and let's see. Wait, since the design is so dark, can't see anything. Yeah, this one is better. Let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. See, as you can see, it breaks. And next slide, so like that. The third slide is origami. And origami, and next, you can play a sound like arrow, bomb, breeze, camera, no. Click, drum roll, explosion, hammer, lift, push. Let's take whoosh. Let's check. See? Or since this is smash, let's take bomb. See? It's bomb. And on mouse click after how many seconds you want. And next we have new tab. As I said that this it's a new tab in the ribbon, and you can add new groups to it. Like you can add new groups if you come here and more commands, you can add new groups to here. You can add new groups, but you'll learn all of that in the next lesson. And next, you go to the animations. This is where we can animate something like this 3D station, 3D sphere. You can arrive or appear or leave. Select options left, maybe strong. And if you want to add another animation to it, you can just add animation. Let's see. Spin, grow, fade. Me, it's spinning. Spin two times. And add animation. Go straight. But it always goes down, so you go effect options. Go from left. No, that's from right to right. Okay. And we come to slideshow, as we can see. And I click it. Ooh. I click it, and without clicking it, it disappeared. And then, since it disappeared, I could not see it move. So let's go move again. And remove the first one, which is leave. Let's see again. Like that. Click it. Click O. And if you want both of that to be at the same time, you go to animation pane. Select all. With previous. I'm gonna call it this. With previous. Now they both happen at the same time. Let's see. See, it's like now, like a ball rolling down the ground. Want to make it a little bit far? You can just click the red dots here, then move it away from it between where you want to place, and then that's how you do it. Let's see the slideshow. See, as you can see, it goes. Okay. And if you want this to happen after previous without clicking it again, you can do after previous. Let's see. And click. And after this stops, it will move. And then I click it. Origami. Origami. And then next. My name's Habib, 11 years old. And that's all for today's lesson. Thanks for watching this video, this lesson. Make sure to like and subscribe. Bye.